Good afternoon and welcome to our service Sunday at 4, Wholeness and Healing. We're going to begin with singing our first hymn, which is hymn 48, Christ Be With Me. And because of the new restrictions, I'm going to ask you please to wear your mask in church as we are legally required to do so, but also to wear your mask while singing, because it seems to me that that's a sensible precaution. We've kept safe so far in the parish, and I'd like to continue that happening. So please stand to sing hymn 48. So welcome to our service of wholeness and healing in St. Christopher's Church on this Sunday afternoon. I'm Reverend Anne and I am the vicar here, and I welcome you whether you're here in person or whether you are at home. It is good to gather. We're going to begin, before we even get to our order of service, with lighting our Advent calendar candles. And I wonder whether I've got a volunteer to come forward. Do I have a volunteer to come forward to light the Advent wreath for me? It's okay, I will do it, don't worry, don't worry. Today we're lighting the two purple candles which we have lit over the past 2 weeks. So we'll light those first. So for the patriarchs and for the prophets. And today we light a candle for John the Baptist on this Gaudete Sunday, the Sunday on which we rejoice. God, our Father, you gave to Zechariah and Elizabeth in their old age a son called John. He grew up strong in spirit, prepared the people for the coming of the Lord, and baptized them in the Jordan to wash away their sins. Help us who have been baptized into Christ to be ready to welcome him into our hearts, and to grow strong in faith by the power of the Spirit. We ask this through Jesus Christ, the light who is coming into the world. We light this candle to remind us of John the Baptist, who passed God's message, "Get ready for your King." So grace and peace be with you. The love of God has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us to dwell in him and lives in us. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to God, sing praises to his name, and speak of all his marvelous works. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. And so we have our collect for healing. Heavenly Father, you anointed your Son Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit and with power to bring us the blessings of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we who share in his suffering and victory may bear witness to the gospel of salvation. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please do be seated as we listen to our first reading.
Our first reading is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 35. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, "Be strong, do not fear, here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For waters shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The haunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveller, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come upon it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We stand now to sing hymn 66, Open Our Eyes. Please do remain standing for the Gospel of the Lord. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Now the time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "None of your relatives has this name." Then they began motioning to his father to find out what name he wanted to give him. He asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." And all of them were amazed. Immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue freed, and he began to speak, praising God. Fear came over all their neighbors, and all these things were talked about throughout the entire hill country of Judea. All who heard them pondered them and said, "What then will this child become? For indeed the hand of the Lord was with him." Then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and began this prophecy. "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably on his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Savior for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that we would be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us. Thus he has shown the mercy promised to our ancestors." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please do be seated. Today on Gaudete Sunday, we are invited to rejoice, hence the stole, rejoice always. Even rejoice always. Rejoice has been taken from the opening verses of this morning's reading from St. Paul to the Philippians. And so I am wearing the pink stole, and we have lit the pink candle on our Advent wreath. Today is a day to notice all the good things God has done for us. On this day when the church also remembers the work and life of John the Baptist. Now it might seem strange, it might be making you wonder, what has John the Baptist got to do with wholeness and healing? So let's just consider what wholeness and healing means for us as part of our relationship with God. In our baptism, we receive the gift of God's saving power, his salvation. We are made new in Jesus Christ. This is the ministry that the child John grew into. He called people to repent of their sins, to be baptized in their readiness to meet the coming Messiah. In our baptism, we know the Messiah has already arrived, and we are all given new life in baptism. In our baptisms, we received the sign of the cross. We were marked with the badge of Christ, the sign of forgiveness of ourselves individually and corporately. It is through the incarnation of God that this renewal begins, the renewal spoken about long before by the prophet Isaiah, the being made whole. We read in our Bibles that healing is physical healing, but it's also spiritual healing. Physical healing is not simply that bones will be healed. It is so much more. In sickness, there is weakness. And that is not just the body being tired. It is being powerless and vulnerable. These are all open to being made whole and being healed. To quote what the Church of England has to say about healing, healing and reconciliation and restoration are integral to the good news of Jesus Christ. For this reason, for individuals focused through laying on of hands or anointing with oil has a proper place within the public prayer of the church. In our reading from the prophet Isaiah, we heard that God's people will have a way to salvation known as the Holy Way. This week, we have learnt that coronavirus has mutated into the fast-spreading Omicron variant. We have learnt of our need to revert to wearing face coverings when we are indoors. We have learnt that to have had the booster jab is, as far as scientists can currently tell, the best way to reduce the impact on those who contract this variant. God is the God of healing. God has given scientific gifts to people to develop vaccines. He has given gifts of care and patience, treatment, and the use of medication developed by scientists to our medical practitioners, to doctors, nurses, carers, and all involved in the care of others. He has given to us, his children, the path to walk on, the path that will keep us safe. And it is up to us to be on the holy way, the way to God, the way that everyone, including the weak and the vulnerable, are invited to travel. The chapter we heard from Isaiah has the title, The Return of the Redeemed to Zion, otherwise known as The Ransomed of the Lord Shall Return. And while this was written to encourage the Old Testament exiles to trust that God would bring them back home to Israel, as Christians, we talk about going home, meaning returning to God, to our heavenly home. We are meaning that when our death arrives, we will be restored, returned to be in the nearer presence of God. And we're trusting that God has everyone and everything in hand. We saw this healing, this being made whole in our gospel reading, the culmination of the healing of barrenness. Elizabeth and Zechariah are made whole. They are restored from the cultural shame of being childless. And while their son, John the Baptist, is attributed with being the first prophet after Malachi, we hear in this passage that Zechariah, as his voice is opened, proclaims the prophecy that he has received as he served in the temple. The prophecy that is proclaimed at every morning prayer, every day in churches and homes around the world. The prophecy that the angel gave to Zechariah is recited as a reminder that in each and every day, we are to join with Zechariah in proclaiming, in sharing with the world, our family and friends, the difference having God in our lives makes to us. In Zechariah, we hear that the pain of being voiceless and childless is a cause for thanksgiving, for praise, and for sharing the good news of the prophecy. There is no bitterness. For Zechariah has been healed in so many ways. His voice has been restored. His standing in the community has been restored. And then he shares with his son and all who listen that work that God has given him. future accomplishments that will be achieved in and through the ministry that John the Baptist has been given. In this canticle, the Benedictus, Zechariah shares the sense of liberation he is feeling. He knows himself to have been set free, to have been made whole, to have been healed. Zechariah is free to worship and to praise God. This is healing, being fully connected with God, completely made whole. That is whole in the sight of God, walking the holy way, on our way, in God's time, back home. And on this Gaudete Sunday, the day on which we join with the whole of God's people, those here present, those online, those who have already gone home and those who we are yet to know, we rejoice as God's people, people who in our many and varied ways reveal to the people we know the transformation that God has made and continues to make in our lives. Let us together give thanks to God for his love of all his children, of those who've gone before, of those yet to be born, and of us. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ went about preaching the gospel and healing. He commanded his disciples to lay hands on the sick that they might be healed. So let us pray. God the Father, your will for all peoples is health and salvation. We praise and bless you, Lord. God the Son, you came that we might have life and might have it more abundantly. We praise and bless you, Lord. God the Holy Spirit, you make our bodies the temple of your presence. We praise and bless you, Lord. Holy Trinity, one God, in you we live and move and have our being. We praise and bless you, Lord. Lord, grant your healing grace to all who are sick, injured, or disabled, that they may be made whole. Hear us, Lord of life. Grant to all who are lonely, anxious, or depressed, a knowledge of your will and an awareness of your presence. Hear us, Lord of life. Grant to all who minister to those who are suffering, wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience. Hear us, Lord of life. Mend broken relationships and restore in those in distress soundness of mind and serenity of spirit. Hear us, Lord of life. Sustain and support those who seek your guidance and lift up all who are brought low by the trials of this life. Hear us, Lord of life. Grant to the dying peace and a holy death, and uphold by the grace and consolation of your Holy Spirit those who are bereaved. Hear us, Lord of life. Restore to wholeness whatever is broken by human sin in our lives, in our nation, in the world. Hear us, Lord of life. You are the Lord who does mighty wonders. You have declared your power among the peoples. With you, Lord, is the well of life. and in your light do we see light. Hear us, Lord of life. Heal us and make us whole. Let us pray. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. The gospel calls us to turn away from sin, to be faithful to Christ. As we offer ourselves to him in penitence and faith, we renew our confidence and trust in his mercy. Cast your burden upon the Lord, and he will sustain you. In returning and rest, you shall be saved. In quietness and trust shall be your strength. Let us silently confess our sins to God, who stands ready to receive us with love, forgiveness, and peace. Let us pray together. Merciful Father, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, the Father of mercies, has reconciled the world to himself through the death and resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ, not holding our sins against us, but sending his Holy Spirit to shed abroad his love among us. By the ministry of reconciliation entrusted by Christ to his church, receive his pardon and peace, to stand before him in his strength alone, this day and forevermore. Amen. We'll sing now, Purify My Heart. And I think we can remain seated for that. So that's hymn 113.
Purify my heart.
Please do stand. Praise to God who made heaven and earth, who keeps his promise forever. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God, who is worthy of all thanksgiving and praise. Blessed are you, sovereign God, gentle and merciful, creator of heaven and earth. Your word brought light out of darkness, and daily your spirit renews the face of the earth. When we turned away from you in sin, your anointed Son took our nature and entered our suffering, to bring your healing to those in weakness and distress. He broke the power of evil and set us free from sin and death, that we might become partakers of his glory. His apostles anointed the sick in your name, bringing wholeness and joy to a broken world. By your grace renewed each day, you continue the gifts of healing in your church, that your people may praise your name forever. By the power of your Spirit, may your blessing rest on those who are anointed with this oil in your name. May they be made whole in body, mind, and spirit. Hear the prayer we offer for all your people. Remember in your mercy those for whom we pray. Heal the sick, raise the fallen, strengthen the faint-hearted, and enfold in your love the fearful and those who have no hope. In the fullness of time, complete your gracious work. Reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, that we may be restored in your image, renewed in your love, and serve you as sons and daughters in your kingdom, through your anointed Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit we lift our voices of thanks and praise. Blessed be God, our strength and our salvation, now and forever. Amen. And so now I invite any who wish to come forward to receive a healing prayer and anointing to do so. The Lord Almighty, who is a strong tower for all who put their trust in him, whom all things in heaven, on earth, and under the earth obey, be now and evermore your defense. May you believe and trust that the only name under heaven given for health and salvation is the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so in confidence, let us pray to the Father for the coming of the kingdom among us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We're going to sing now, Holy is His Name, which is hymn 100. Please do find that and then stand when you're ready.
Oh,
God who said, let light shine out of darkness, has caused his light to shine within us, to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God, revealed in the face of Jesus Christ. We have this treasure in earthen vessels to show that the power belongs to God. Hear the words of the Gospel according to St. Luke. Once Jesus was asked by the Pharisee when the kingdom of God was coming, and he answered, the kingdom of God is not coming with things that can be observed, or they will say, look, here it is, or there it is. For in fact, the kingdom of God is among you. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. God has made us one in Christ. He has set his seal upon us, and as a pledge of what is to come, has given the Spirit to dwell in our hearts. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Go in the joy and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. We're going to sing now our final hymn, hymn 33, Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. When you can find your words, we will sing. Brothers and sisters, our service has ended. We gather now to share a time of fellowship. God bless you all and online.